We are very good at just opening primordials, the white primordial. This one is pretty nice. If we were Boros, no, we still probably would take like a mugging, which I think is what we still take here. Pretty decent playables. There's like a Clefkin Raptor, Skinbrand Goblin, Assault Griffin, Purged, Hybridization, and Holy Mantle. They're all decent cards, but having more cheap removal, always nice. Hopefully we can table the Skinbrand Goblin. That would be kind of nice. Okay, so here it's between the Skinbrand Goblin and the Warmind Infantry. And a Skinbrand Goblin is nice, but I think I like the Warmind Infantry more. It's better with Pit Fight, and we already have a couple. We already have several Blood Rush combat tricks, so I think I'd rather have a Warmind Infantry. And we also just have one 3-drop here, so. Once again, that could be wrong. Might just want infinite 2-drops, but I feel like that might be more of a Boro strategy. Okay. Well, we're going to take a Bomber Corps here, but it's, you know, one of the weaker cards in this pack. There's a third pick Elusive Crassus and Thrall Parasite and some other good cards, but Bomber Corps it is. Yeah, I'm actually not sure about that one. Skinbrand Goblin, Warmind Infantry. Jeez, okay, so there's like a Gift of Orzhova, which is very, very good. We probably just lose to this card. Can't do much against it, but yeah, obviously we can't play this. There's not much here for us. There's a Foundry Street Denizen and a Sylvan Primordial. Sylvan Primordial is large, but it does cost 7. And we have no ramp. Still probably better than like a Foundry Street Denizen. Alright. Let's just take the fatty. I'm not sure if we're going to play this, but yeah. Wow. We're really getting cut off here. This is just mono Orzhov pack. So I'm just going to D like the best Orzhov card, I guess. So Guild Mage it is. And move on. All right, let's take a Prophetic Prism. Maybe we'll splash white or something, I don't know. Cycles itself. All right, there's a... Blind Obedience. I don't know how many tickets this is worth, probably like one or two. I'm going to take another Spire Tracer here. Let's take an Angelic Edict in case we want to splash it. We might actually end up being some kind of Boros deck. Who knows? Guess Dutiful Thrall is kind of annoying. Yeah, like we could potentially be like, if we don't have enough playables, we can be like red green splash Knight of Obligation and Angelic Edict. Yeah, I don't know. This deck didn't end up like ridiculous or anything, but it can win some games probably. We got some removal spells, a Gruul Charm. Ugh. Misclicks for the loss. Hide black. Hide blue. I'm just gonna D that. Don't really want to play against Aether Eyes. All right, we got some sideboard against flyers. Think something like this, maybe. This is assuming we want to go into white, which might not be necessary. It's probably not. Like, yeah. Probably not worth it. If they have something that's really tough to deal with, then we'll probably bring in the white. But for now, let's just try to keep it. Keep it two colors. Keep it civil. Well, I don't want to put the primordial in right away. All right, so that's 18 cards that are very likely making the deck. And now we need five cards, I guess. So yeah, we have plenty of on color playable, so I don't think we really need to splash. So the question becomes, what do we play? Definitely something cheaper, so I guess the gargoyle gets in there. And So I think I'm going with this. I actually like need the prophetic prism just as a filler. So I'm gonna just cut the Sylvan Primordial and just kind of lower the curve. I wanted to just top out at six, and I just tossed in the Towering Thunderfist just because it's just a cheaper creature to play, still good with Pit Fight, and we can actually use the white ability. So I'm gonna go like this. Then let's add, suggest. Don't need that many mountains. Can go to like eight mountains, six forests, 14, 15. Probably want seven forests. Go like this. This gives us three white sources, 10 red sources, I guess, and eight green sources. Yeah. Yeah, so three, four, five, six, seven. Yeah, we need to play seven forests if we're playing the Spire Tracers. All right. All right, let's give this a go. We could also just like go fatties and cut some of the low drops. But then like bomber cores also get kind of worse. And like taking them all out is, I don't know, pretty bad. If we play against a really slow do-nothing deck, maybe we can just sideboard into fatties, but I'm gonna try this for now.